Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more blood, fresh supply. Last time, we had some fun fighting some fire puppers in some lava back there. And now, this level, this is where it gets serious. This, we're known as nothing but monster bait in this level. This is a tough level, and it takes place near and inside a dam. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool level design. I like the design of this level a lot. However, nice. This level is really unforgiving. You don't get a whole lot of breaks in this level from enemies. I mean, this is a tough level, and it's not so much. And it goes with what I've been saying all along about this game. It's not the number of enemies in the level; it's the enemy placement is what makes it so tough. But very rarely do you get a break in here. Like, it pretty much lasts. I mean, you. Action pretty much happens until right at the very end. But up here, you can get to that secret just by jumping normally. You don't need the jump boots. That secret's kind of reminiscent of one way back in episode 1 of Duke 3D, if you remember. Now right here, yep, we don't get a bridge, so we gotta jump across. The rock wall lowers. And we have all these frickin' fanatics here. Frickin' fanatics. And, lovely, lovely. So we'll head on up. Wow, send him flying. Yeah, it's a pretty cool level, though. I love the waterfalls and the, just the flowing water down below. You don't have to jump into the water at all at any point during this level, fun fact. It's more of just a, it's more of a thing where if you fall into the water, you can find like little passageways to get back up to the main path, up to where you were. But yeah, you get to run through some waterfalls if you go down there. It's pretty neat. Anyway, into the danger area next. Oh, this frickin' room is tough. Okay, easy, fellas. Let's grab that. I'm gonna go ahead and use some health here. Stay back, boys. Okay, alright, so they're dead. And now we've just got regular cultists in here. Well, there is a second one. I don't know where the other one went, though. But we can hit the switches on the walls, but they don't open the doors. They instead cut the lights on. The way we proceed is by hitting this switch at the center. And we can go through here and take out some of the bloated butchers. Get this guy behind him here, the fire will reach. There we go. Woohoo, woohoo, woohoo. Sounds like they're whining at me there. Anyway, go up here, hit the switch, grab the napalm. Hit this switch, which opens this up. Yeah, here. There we go. Lights, please. There we go, and we'll hit that. Some more spray cans if you need them. Hit this, and now we can go into the next section here. This is, here's a pretty cool little thing here. Hit both of the levers, and get ready for a fight. Because when these doors open, you want to crouch, because we got a stone gargoyle, so let's take him out. And I would use the voodoo doll on him, but I don't think I've used the Tesla cannon against a stone gargoyle yet. Yeah, there he goes. He'll go right down to it, of course, as will most every other enemy in the game. And he'll drop a life seed. So, this switch cannot be activated yet. What we gotta do... I'm gonna try and not to grab the guns akimbo yet. I wanna hit this... Come on now. Hit this lever. Yeah. Pull this lever. Lower down the elevator. Grab guns akimbo. Get onto the elevator. That way we can use it for as much as we can here. So open this up. Run to the left. Get rid of that guy. And just send a bullet barrage on the way to those guys there. So, now, when we get into this part here, we're gonna go down this way. So from the door that we used to get into this place, we're gonna go to the right. Now, anybody... Yeah, there might be a guy down there. Anyway, in here's a life seed with a secret. And we're gonna sneak around this way. Wah! Those guys. Yeah. All kinds of pretty light shows in this level. And we'll do the same thing with those cultists down there. Ooh, got him. Got him. Yeah, that'll teach you. That'll teach you to mess with Caleb. Ooh, hellhound. Can't use no fire against him. There we go. Now, we'll hit this, we'll activate this computer here. And that will allow us to, ooh, don't want to go up there yet. I want a sequence break. It burns! It burns! So yeah, grab up the armor, hit the second computer here, and this, yes. This allows you to access a secret here.
Now. Locked.
Locked. Oh, that's right. But my mistake, it doesn't allow you, well, one of them allows you to access a secret, the other allows you to just proceed in general. Ugh, what? Stop looking at me like that, man. Anyway, let's go up this ramp. Spray cans. This door is locked, and we will jump over here, and over here, and here. And of course, you don't even need to do this if you have the jump boots, but yeah, grab the life seed for a secret, and you can drop onto the moon key. So with all that stuff collected, full-on Tesla ammo, I like it, we can head out of here. And I'm going to jump into the water. We can grab the shells. Freaking fanatic. Yeah, get rid of him. And his buddy, alright. So we can go over here. This door lowers down, back into the area we were just in. And in here's another secret with Beast Vision. So now we'll go up the elevator. Yeah, that's the tricky thing about this level, is that the elevators don't... they don't activate when you activate them. You have to cross, like, a trigger line in order to activate them. Which can make things difficult, especially if there's enemies in the next area, and you'll see a prime example of that in a little bit here coming up. So, nothing else in this room other than a voodoo doll and some cultists. So, over this way, we'll go down across the bridge, collect any ammo, and we will open up the door with our moon key. Whoa! I forgot he was there. Now there's another guy up there. There we go. Oop! Almost forgot about this guy. Yeah, come on. I know you wanna... yeah, come on up them stairs. What are you using stairs for? Ghosts don't need stairs. Get out of here. Anyway, remote bombs. And some Tommy gun ammo. Now, here's a little bit of a puzzle. So, we've got these three red bars. We need to turn these lights and these bars blue in order to proceed, because we've got three doors we need to open up. Like, you know, sequentially. So what you do, hit the switch. Now see, watch the little flickering arrow on the ground. Hit the switch a second time and it turns, see? Now that'll close off, but one of the doors through there opens up, and see, the bar turns blue. Hit it a third time, and now this panel opens up. So what we want to do is activate this panel three times to where the third bar is blue. Hit the switch again to turn the arrow, and then just keep hitting it again until you see the panel here. Hit this one time, and then hit the turning switch again. And yeah, that'll open up that'll open up all the doors for you. So the way you do it is you hit this one three times, you hit this one time, and then the second door opens when the arrow is pointing at the doors. So yes, we've got tons of napalm. Let's just dispose of all these frickin' guys here. Hey, knock it off. Anyhow, let's go around, press the button, which will turn the mechanism there, allowing us to proceed. On up this way. Hit it again. Now, there is TNT in the water in that corner. And if you activate the bridge, what you can do, if you jump back down, I mean, yeah, that's it. That's in here. There's some Tesla ammo in here. If you activate the bridge to go back to the other side again, and that will take you close to the beginning there. What you can do is you don't have to do that whole sequence over again. You can use your jump boots to get back across. So, with that... ah, they've been expecting us here. Very nice. Now, with some dynamite... Yeah, we'll toss a bundle and watch those guys. Yeah, watch the fireworks there. So. Sweet! Lovely dynamite placement, if I do say so myself. Alright, we have another doctor's bag around here. Blow them up. Just don't even think about it. Just blow them up. So, this elevator. Here's what I was talking about earlier. You get on it, right? Quickly run to the left. Oh, good. I got the other guy. But you saw, I mean, just how quickly I got wrecked there. And even though I didn't die, they still took a ton of damage. Now, another thing you can do, if you want, is you can place some frickin' remote bombs and then send the elevator down and then just blow them up to get the fanatics. But you know me, I like living a little dangerously here. Living on the edge. In video games, that is. Anyhow, this goes back to the Moon Key area. We're good on Tesla ammo. So, now we'll just go the other way, down through here, and we open this door and we come to a storage area. Wow! okay, don't need any of that. We'll take those. Okay, grab the life essence. And look outside. Ooh. Yes, looks like we got a ton of water, of course. And yeah, there's the dam right there. So, let's open this door up. We get a phantasm. Ooh, yeah, don't open that door there, buddy. There's a good reason we don't need him to open that door early. There we go. Yeah, here's a better view of it. Yeah, so you can see the dam in all its glory here. And, yeah. Well, the reason we don't want to open the door yet... I mean, now we're good. Three Hellhounds. So just use the secondary Tesla fire on them. And I'm going to go ahead and activate this. Because... ugh, man. Two burps in one episode. What the heck is going on with me? Anyway, yeah, we got gargoyles here. And this door is not... helping me. Okay, good. Good, good, good. We got him. Yeah, I was about to say that door is not helping me in any way here, but we got the gargoyles. And as soon as this elevator comes back down, we will take it on up through here. And we are now on top of the dam. Pretty neat stuff. So let's grab the fire key. Now, if you jump over into the water here, there's nothing in here except for a tiny little passageway you can swim through. That will take you back to close to the start of the map. But we don't want to go back there. And we also don't want to drown. So let's go ahead and get back up on top here. So where we want to go is right here. So, Geronimo! Okay. So we get, we jump on in. Fire some napalm. Yeah, Caleb thinks that's funny. And we blow a hole open in the dam. And when you do that, all the water from that side is going to start flooding this side here. And this gives you access to the final secret of the map, right down in here, with some ammo. And it also allows you to jump back up through the windows to get into the previous area. And there's an area down... oh no, you can't swim through here. It's just, it's barred off. But anyway, where we really want to go is all the way over here. Here's how we leave this place here. This little literal hole in the wall, little entrance here. With the fire key, we lower down the altar. And that opens up the door here. And, ooh, very hellish. So, when you're ready, step inside. And that is Monster Bait. Yeah, I would say probably the hardest level in the episode. Which, now you know what that means, that because there's only 8 maps instead of 9, like there were in the previous episode, next time, I will see you in the Pit of Cerberus. We've finally made it, and we will see Cerberus and all his glory next time. So until then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll catch you later.